वन्दे वाञ्छितलाभाय वन्दे वाञ्छितलाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दम्पतिमिति ब्रूयाम् उदाहो दम्पति इति. वी वर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द गद्यं, रैट्? हा, इदं च परमाद्भुतम् उत्प्रेक्षितं तस्यां यत्किल विविधतपः प्रबन्धनिस्तन्द्रतया निस्तन्द्रतया विस्मृतलोकतन्त्रेषु चिरधृतब्रह्मचर्यजीर्णतया कालमृत्युषु Kandarpasya Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. So I was talking about the Vyaja Stuti that he uses here, where he actually praises the Brahmarshis who are constantly pulled by the Sadvasana that they have, the Shubha Vasana that they have. They are constantly in that. They are unable to remove themselves from that. See, don't look at it as a ninda. This is not a ninda param. It may look like apparently a ninda param, but it is not. It is more of a stuti param. And the rest of the paragraphs follow, paragraph follows about how they behave when they have to enjoy with the apsaras. Okay? A lot of things are quite explicit in this, but it's fun. So bhutalat agatya prasakteshu bhutalat agatya apsarobihi kriditum prasakteshu. We stopped with that. So they came from the bhulokam where they have been practicing brahmacharya and different types of vratam. So how would they behave when they start to play with the apsaras? That is, when they start to enjoy their time with the apsaras, can they actually do that? In the sense of enjoying the vishayas that they see in front of them. They are unable to do that because their vasana balam is very high. That's what he's trying to say in this. Why don't you start? Shri? Yeah.
The full sentence, or
you can read one by one so that I'll keep explaining each one. It's easier that way.
Padmashala pravishama iti pravishatsu keli gruham.
So keli gruham is the place where they have to be with the apsarastri. It is keli is krida. So krida griham pravishatsu. They enter the krida griham by saying that parnashalam pravishamaha. Let's enter the ashrama. They are unable to let go of the vasana. They are so used to talking about that. No, now, you have to think of it in terms of how a mother has two children and they will constantly keep mixing up the names. You know, the younger one will come and say, why are you calling me by the older one's name? The older one will say, why are you calling me by the younger one's name? It's about more of what you're used to it. So they are so used to talking about their house as ashrama or parnashala. They keep saying parnashalam pravishamaha iti keli griham pravishatsu. As they enter the play area, they think that it is ashrama. They say, let's get into the ashrama.
This vistram saya jatam iti veni malam
alamba maneshu.
Veni malamba maneshu.
Yeah. Veni malamba maneshu. The apsarastris have veni. They have pinnal, no, we call it. So that while they are asking them to let loose their hair, they're saying visramsaya jatam iti veni malamba maneshu. They catch hold of their hair but say the let loose your jata, not the veni. Next one.
Apanaya valkam ityapanetu kameshu kuchadukulani.
Kuchadukulani apanetu kameshu apanaya valkalam iti. So they say apanaya valkalam. Apanaya valkalam, or valkalam is bark, bark garment. Remove your bark garment. So saying, they try to remove the cloth that is there on their breasts. So kucha dukulani apanetu kameshu, to remove the vastram, they say remove your bark garment. Next.
Na lohitam kuryaditi nishedhatsu nakat kshatani.
Nakhakshatani, these are the marks of the nakha, the nails, that you normally get when you are engaged in such union. So that nakakshatani, the moment that there is a mark of the nail, it becomes red because the blood comes to the surface, right? So for that, instead of saying don't do nakakshata, they say na lohitam kuryat. Lohitam is kumkumam or rakta chandanam. It's like applying the red sandalwood on top or kumkumam on top. So na lohitam kuryat, do not apply any kumkumam. Iti nishedatsu nakakshatani. So it's saying they stop them from doing any marks with the nails.
Kashtama sammata toyam pantaha shishtanam iti pita karneshu chumbana bheda prastavanayam.
Prastavanayam. Chumbana Veda Prastavanayam Pihita Karneshu. The moment they try to kiss, Chumbana is kissing. So Chumbana Veda Prastavanayam. Prastavana is the beginning or introduction. They're just starting to do that. And at that point of time, Pihita Karneshu, they close their ears saying, Ah Kashtam. Asammatoyam pantaha shishtana. Shishtanam, people who are in a following the proper path. Shishtanam, I am pantaha, this marga, this path is asammatam. It is not acceptable. This is not acceptable. So saying, they close their ears. Pihita karneshu. Next one.
Nivita dharana vyagreshu nivi mochana mochana vasare mantra japa mukhareshu manita vasare.
I'll stop with that. So nivita, I can't see this, 1 minute. Nivita dharana vyakreshu nivi mochana avasare. Nivi mochana avasare. Nivi is the cloth that is tied on the hip. That is called nivi. When nivi mochana avasare, while trying to remove that cloth at that time, avasare, nivita dharana vyakreshu. Nivitam ityukte yajnyopavitasya mala rupena kanthe dharana. That is when people are doing something ashaucha, visiting the restroom or something like that. They are supposed to take the yajnopavitam and put it in the around the kantha in the form of a garland. So that particular thing is called nivitam. Nivita dharana vyagreshu. They are very involved, vyagra. They are involved in wearing their yajnopavitam around their neck when they have to be removing the cloth. Mantra japa mukhareshu manita avasare. Manitam is the murmur that they do during the rati kala. Rati is samboga. During the samboga kala, the murmurs or the sweet nothings that you try to say, right, to each other. At that point of time, mantra japa mukhareshu, they are constantly saying mantras, mantra japa.
Smrita madhya vyati pata ityantara gantu kameshu.
Smritam adhya vyati pata iti antara gantu kameshu. Antara, in between, when they have just started, getting together, at that point of time, in the middle, antara gantu kameshu, they want to get out. Now, what do they say when they are getting out? They're saying, I just remembered that it is Vyatipata. Vyatipata is a type of yoga. In a day, there are many different yogas where Surya, Chandra, this, that one comes together, Rahu and Suryan come together and all these things. So each one, you say Shubha Yoga, Shubha Tithi, Shubha Dina and all that during Sankalpa, right? That Shubha Yoga, there are actually 27 yogas. Some say there are 28 yogas, I'm not sure. But it starts off with Vishkambaka, etc. In that you have Amrita Yoga, Marana Yoga. The main thing we see is Siddha Yogam, Amrita Yogam, Marana Yogam. All these are the things that we see. There are other different types of yogas also. In that, Vyatipata is extremely ashubha kalam. It is the 17th yoga in the set of 27 yogas. So that it is an extremely ashubha kalam in the sense nothing should be started. Prarambhasya ashubha suchyate. So asmritam, I suddenly remembered, adya vyatipataha. Now it is not the correct time, it is an ashubha kalam. Iti antara gantukameshu. And immediately they want to go in the middle.
अनुयोजनेषु पुनरार्थवदीनानि शपथपूर्वकम्.
सो पुनः पुनः आर्तवदिनानि शपथपूर्वकम् अनुयुञ्जानेषु. अनुयुञ्जानेषु अनुयुनक्ति मीन्स् पृच्छति. सो दे कीप् आन् आस्किङ्ग्. आर्तवदिनम् Arthavam is actually that Ritu Kalam. There are two variations as to what is Arthavadinam. Arthavadinam, they say, is the time of the menses, or it is the time after the menses, which is the Garbhadana Yogya Kalam. The ovulating period or the menses, it's completely, I don't know which is correct. So contextually, we have to take it. So here, they just keep on continuously asking them whether it is your Ritu Dinam or not. ఆర్తవే దినాని శపథపూర్వకం. శపథపూర్వకం మీన్స్ టెల్ మీ ట్రూత్ఫుల్లీ, ఇస్ ఇట్ ట్రూ ఆర్ నాట్, ఇస్ ఇట్ ట్రూ ఆర్ నాట్, ఆర్ యూ ఆర్ నాట్. పునః పునః అనయుంజానేషు, బికాస్ దే ఆర్ సో కన్సర్న్డ్ అబౌట్ దేర్ శిష్టాచారం. దట్ ఈస్ వై
అతిక్రామతి నిషేకలగ్నిమిత్య సమా
లగ్నం, నిషేక లగ్నం,
నిషేక లగ్నం ఇతి ఇత్య అసహమానేషు బాహ్య సురత సురత వ్యాపార విలంబం
వ్యాపార విక్లవం. ఓకే, మేబీ ఐ రోట్ ఇట్ రాంగ్. ఓకే, సో అతిక్రామతి నిషేక లగ్నం ఇతి అసహమానేషు బాహ్య సురత వ్యాపార విలంబం. కరెక్ట్, విలంబం ఇస్ రైట్. నా బాహ్య సురత వ్యాపార విలంబం అసహమానేషు, దే డోంట్ వాంట్ ఎనీ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ డిలే. వెన్ దే వాంట్ టు హ్యావ్ దట్ యూనియన్ అట్ దట్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్, నిషేక లగ్నం అతిక్రామతి. నిషేక ఇస్ గర్భాధాన సమయ. దట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ టైమ్ దట్ లగ్నం అతిక్రామతి, ఇట్ విల్ పాస్. సో వీ షుడ్ హరీ. So they don't spend much time on bahya surata vyapara vilambam. They don't delay much on outside enjoyments like foreplay, etc. So they say, they think that it is unnecessary because it is the perfect time for garbhadhana. Next,
avadhira yatsu purushayitam.
పురుషాయితం అవధీరయత్సు. పురుషాయితం ఈస్ పురుష ఇవ ఆచరితం. ఇట్ ఈస్ అ టైప్ ఆఫ్ రతి క్రీడ ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ వేర్ ద ఉమెన్ యాక్ట్స్ లైక్ అ మ్యాన్. దాట్ ద అవధీరయత్సు, దే ఆర్ కంప్లీట్లీ దే డోంట్ థింక్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కరెక్ట్. నెక్స్ట్, దే లుక్ డౌన్ అపాన్ విమెన్ హూ ట్రై టు డూ దట్. దట్స్ వాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్.
అసమన్యమానేషు బంధభేదాన్.
బంధభేదాన్, బంధభేదాన్, ద డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ పాస్చర్స్ దట్ హవ్ బీన్ ఎంజాయిన్డ్ ఆర్ దట్ హవ్ బీన్ సెడ్ ఇన్ కామశాస్త్ర, దే డు నాట్ అక్సెప్ట్ ఆల్ దోస్. అసమన్యమానేషు, దే డు నాట్ థింక్ హైలీ ఆఫ్ ఇట్, దే డోంట్ రిగార్డ్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ హైలీ.
విగాయత్సు విటీకోపసేవనమప్యనుచిత్తోయం కాల ఇతి.
వీటికా ఉపసేవనం.
ఓ, వీటికోపసేవనం.
వీటికోపసేవనం. సో విగాయత్సు వీటికా ఉపసేవనమపి అనుచితః అయం కాలః ఇతి. అయం కాలః అనుచితః, దిస్ టైమ్ ఈస్ నాట్ కరెక్ట్ టు హ్యావ్ వెత్తల, యు నో ద బీటిల్ నట్ దట్ యు చ్యూ, beetle leaves, that is called vitika, tambulavalli. The vitika, this is not the correct time to chew the beetles. You usually do it either after lunch and then you have it so that it's you can chew upon it. That should be had only in the afternoon. And at night, if they want to have it, this is all part of the Rati Krida that they are talking about. Okay. So you offer betel nuts, betel leaves to each other, and that upasevanam, to take that betel leaves, is anuchitaha ayam kalaha iti vigayatsu. They talk about it. Vigayati means, I think they nindati. Yeah, that's what I was trying to talk. They censure the act of taking betel leaves.
Ananda murchavasara eva nibhrutam. Nibhrutam anusaram anusaradhaneshu anusandhaneshu mangalani
nibhrutam mantra lingani is there
mantra lingani kshamyate
right nibhrutam anusandhaneshu ananda murcha avasare eva ananda murcha avasare at the point when they have to revel in the happiness of the enjoyment at that point ananda murcha avasara murcha is actually being unconscious with happiness. At that point of time, avasare eva, what they do is mantra lingani, the mantras and the different identifications or the chinnam, the mudras, you do iti avahyami and all that. There are things that go for the shakti upasana and everything. For upasanas, you have the different mantras that you use to do the mantranga. That they keep on anusandhaneshu, they keep remembering all those things. Nibhritam, continuously. Or nibhritam is also, there are two meanings. One is continuously, there is also nischalam, and there is also rahasyam. So they quietly, without moving, without even thinking about the anandam, they keep on thinking about the mantras. Next.
Paravasharatanta nidravasara eva yavat. Yavat sannipatam sahasayeti pariharatsu paryanka shayikam
saha shayya iti pariharatsu paryanka shayikam. So paryanka shayikam pariharatsu, they don't want to sleep with those apsarastri. So paryanka shayikam, sleeping with them, they pariharatsu, they forego that. Why? Because paravasha ratanta nidra avasare, even though rata anta at the end of sambhoga, nidra avasare, paravasham means they are not conscious of themselves. At that point of time, they just gradually slip into sleep. Even at that point of time, they don't want to do that. Paryanka shayyam pariharatsu. Why? Because yavat sannipatam sahashayya, until the time they sannipatam is they are separated, until the time that they separate from each other automatically, they have to sleep together. They don't like that. The Brahmarshis don't like that, and that is why paryanka shayikam pariharatsu, they leave the bed, forego and leave the bed.
Dvitiya suratarambha eva dehi me kamandalu niti twaramaneshi mandakini gamanaya.
So dvitiya surata arambe, let's go for a second time. That is the dvitiya sambhoga arambha samaye eva. What do they say? They say kamandalum dehi me. Give me my kamandalu, and they go to Mandakini Gamanaya Twaramaneshu. They go to the Ganga Tiram. They quickly, Twaramaneshu, they shikrameva gachatsu. Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. All of these are adjectives to Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. So the Brahmarshi Hatakaha are Brahmarshis who behave like this. Right? When they are behaving in this manner, Devavara Kantaha Rambadi Menakaha Menakantaha Vihasanti. They laugh at their actions. Vishidanti, they are very sad, or they feel very pathetic about the way they are behaving. They feel very sad. They're not able to enjoy. That is one way of looking at it. Dilajjanti, they think of how, their actions are not correct. That also is going on in their mind. Vismayante, they are also... at the end, he says Vismayante, because they feel very surprised with the way their vasana balam is. No? In Yoga Vashishtam, he says, Shubha Shubhanam Marganam Vasana Saritu. Shubha Shubhanam Marganam vahanti vasana sarit. The vasana that we have, the samskara that we have, both shubha and ashubha vasana flow like a river. Shubhanam ashubhanam cha marganam vahanti vasana sarit. Sarit is like a river that just flows with a force. That is how it is in everybody. But what should we do? Where is, see, everybody talks about this free will versus, you know, fate. It's not such a big confusion and all. So what this flow of Shubha Vasana and the flow of Ashubha Vasana is constant in our mind. Whenever we are being pushed into the Ashubha Vasana, Ashubheshu Samavishtam, Shubheshweva Avatarana, Paurushena Prayatnena, Shubhe Pati Niveshaya. What is that? Shubha Shubhanam Marganam Vahanti Vasana Sarit Paurushena Prayatnena Yojaniya Shubhe Pati. Shubhe Pati, in the Shubha Marga, we have to use our effort to put our mind into that. Paurushena Prayatnena Yojaniya Shubhe Pati. That is what they have done. Ashubheshu Samavishtam Shubheshweva Vatarayet. Every time they are encountered with something which is Ashubha, they think of it as Shubha. They talk of it as Shubha. Their mind is so conditioned to think about good things and that which is useful for their progress in this path. Because they have been using, their mind is trained in that path, they are able to bring it easily into the Shubha Vasana. That's what we are trying in our life, right? So there is hope at every point. Bhartrahari says, you know, Agre Gitam, Sarasa Kavayaha, Pashvayoho Dakshinatyaha. You can enjoy as long as you have all these things. If you don't have all these things, then please go into Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, where you think only about that Brahman. No chet chetaha pravisha sahasa nirvikalpe samadho. If you are not able to enjoy it, then go and look at the Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. This is even for those Brahmarishis. You know, you do so much of karma and you end up in Swarga, but that is not the goal. See, their goal is something beyond this. Their goal should be to for Atma Sakshatkara or Moksha. If you are a Karma Kandi, then Swarga is Moksha. That is a different method, but I am an out and out Vedanti, so I can't accept that. It's a different matter. Here, their goal is something different. So they do not want to be led by this path. That's what he is praising them here. More than anything.
Mahadeyatra, Deva Vara Kantaha iti asti kalu.
Yeah.
किमर्थं वार देवकान्ताः इत्येव वक्तुं शक्यते
वारस्त्रियः इत्युक्ते वेश्यास्त्रियः अप्सर दोस् हू अभिसारिका दट् अभिसरन्ते इति अभिसारिकाः दे गो टुवर्ड्स् पुरुष अभिमुखं गच्छन्ति इति वारकान्ताः दे आर् नाट् जस्ट् कान्ताः सी देर् आर् मेनी इवन् सची इस् देवकान्ता इन्द्रास् वैफ् इस् आल्सो देवकान्ता बट् शी इस् नाट् एन् अप्सरस् And even among the apsaras, you have only a set of people who are varakantaha, who are veshyastris, who go and who are there for the enjoyment of the people who come there. So that's why he specifies deva varakantaha and who are specifically rambhadi menakantaha. Now he finishes this and moves to again back to Amaravati. How the margam is. He has to go to Indra and start Indra's description. And that's why now he comes to this. Can someone read? Yeah. Prasajati.
Prasajati mahotsaveva prajalati rathivasa tatra shatreva nimnani purayante pavanamaye thalavrinta pavaneena.
After the description of these people, Bhumi, now there is no sambandham with the Bhumi, right? Amaravati is just standing there without any support. Niralambe Nabhasi. So when it is standing there, what is the margam? What happens when Mahotsave Prasajati Sati? Pavanamaye, it's a very beautiful expression that he says. The whole place is windy. Pavanamaye Tatra. Everywhere it is only wind, pavanam is there, vayu is there. Mahotsave prasajati sati. When there is a mahotsava or a festival that is happening, what will they do? How will they fill up the whole place? When there is a festival, you need some support, you need roads and all that. So how are the whole things, how do they make arrangements? So mahotsave prasajati va, when there is a festival happening, or shakre indre ratyasu prachaliti sati. In this prasajati and prachalati are all sati saptami. It is not the verb. So mahotsave prasajati sati, athava shakre indre ratyasu margeshu prachalati sati, gacchati sati. When he is going on the road, talavrinta pavanena nimnani purayante. Wherever there is a hole, nimna pradesham, wherever there is a hole, talavrintena, they just use one. Talavrintam is a fan made of palm leaf. Talam is palm leaf, and they use that vrinta, that the leaf, as a fan, and they use the wind that comes from that fan and fill up all the low-lying areas. See, when it's a festival, you first have to make a samatalam in order to put up a stage and all that, or people have to move. And if there Indra's chariot has to move also, there should not be any potholes like how there are in the roads here. So we need to fill up all those, right? That is done just by the wind, because it is pavanamaye tatra amaravatyam. So easy, huh? You don't need to spend so much of effort on tar and getting a machine and all that. It's so easy to do this. Blow a fan and you're done. Next one is very nice, where he says, many kavis are very, many poets are very quiet about describing Amaravati. They are not willing to even, say something about it, describe it. Why? Because it is much more than moksha. It is much better than moksha. That's what he says in the shloka. Okay, read.
Khana Shatiriti Amodha Hatiriti Ananda Vispurtiriti Antarvani Vikalpa Jala Jatila Mokshadapi Jayasi Sayesha Avipratipanna Avipratipanna Saukhya Lahari Sampata Sampadini Tat Saundarya Vivechane Kavayatam Maunam Kshamam Divatam.
Tat Saundarya Vivechane Kavayatam Maunam Kshamam Hrimatam. Hrimatam Kavayatam. Those poets are hrimatam. They're very ashamed to even describe about Amaravati. Saundarya vivechane, to analyze about the beauty of Amaravati. Why? Because Amaravati, esha Amaravati, avipratipanna saukhya lahari sampada sampadini. Avipratipanna. See, there he shows the differences between moksha and Amaravati. Amaravati is equal to swargam here. Okay, the difference between moksha and swarga is, moksha is something which you have a huge process there. What is the process? Dukkhanam kshatihi abodha hatihi ananda vispurtihi iti antarvani vikalpa jala jatilat mokshat jayasi. It is jayasi greater sreshtha, mokshadapi sreshtha amaravati. Katham moksham, how is this moksha? It is jatila, it is very complicated. Why is it complicated? Because antarvani vikalpa jala. There are so many scholars who have constantly given, you know, different descriptions about moksha. They have tried to explain moksha, so they have made it more complicated. Antarvani. Antarvani is a antaha vani yasya saha. Shastra vihita vak yasya saha. So there are many scholars who have studied the Shruti, who have studied the different branches of sciences, and they have come up with shastras. Come up with an idea of moksha. How to attain moksha. Vikalpa, antarvani, vikalpa jala jatila. Antarvani scholars, their vikalpa, different types of arguments they have. that jala kutam, that is samuha. Samuha jatila. Jatila is durgnyayam, or it is very difficult, complicated to understand. That sort of a moksha. Because if you see, there are six scientific literature. Those are darshanas, where you have Nyaya Vaisheshika, Sankhya Yoga, Uttara Mimamsa, and Purva Mimamsa. All these shastras have come about to explain the nature of sukham, or explain the nature of moksha. What is this moksha? So Nyaya and Vaisheshika have their own methods, their own arguments. They say, no, 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 Atma, it is Atma Gunam, or it is Mano Gunam. Whatever they try to, you know, you learn the different padarthas that are there in the world, then you attain moksha. That is Nyaya and Vaisheshika. Next, you have Sankhya and Yoga. They don't believe in Shruti, or they say you have a proper living, then you're fine. You have to do these asanas, you have to do meditation, and then after, once you meditate upon what, we don't know. So you meditate and then you will attain moksha. Next we come to Purva Mimamsa. Purva Mimamsa is, they say you perform all these yaga, yajna, you attain moksha. Now that is what is Swarga for us. So let's leave Purva Mimamsa aside for a bit and go to Uttara Mimamsa. Uttara Mimamsa is where, even inside Uttara Mimamsa, let alone these darshanas, leave Nyaya, Vaisheshika, Sankhya, Yoga alone. Let's look at just the Uttara Mimamsa, which is Vedanta. Vedanta, there are different branches. You have Dvaita, Advaita, and Vishishta Advaita. There is Shiva Advaita, Shakta, so many different branches. Even in Advaita, you have so many different branches. In Vishishta Advaita, you have different branches. So why do these things come up? Antarvani Vikalpa Jala Jatila. It has become so complicated to understand moksha, because there have been so many scholars who have tried to contribute to this mass of thoughts that exist. On a surface level, what is it? Dukkanam kshatihi mokshaha iti vadanti. What is dukkha? Adhyatmika, adibhautika, adidaivika. This is according to Vedanta. If you look at Kanada, there are some 21 types of dukkhas that he says. Now, adhyatmika means atmanam adhikritya ye vartante. Yad vartate tat. So, adhyatmikam, adibhautikam, is adhyatmika is actually manas, kayikam and vachikam, or sharirikam, which is kayikam, and then manasikam, which both of those are adhyatmika. If you look at adibhautika, that is bhutani adhikritya yat dukkam. So whatever sarisripa, mruga, vyagra, etc., whatever they have caused us, that is called adibhautika. Adidaivika is something which we don't know. It is beyond our perception. In the sense, devata adhikritya, you look at jatakam, you look at your horoscope, you look at what other people are saying, you go and this is the Rahu is the problem here, this is Ketu is the problem here, that is all adida, or bhuta, pishacha, avesham, that thing is also there. So that sort of a black magic dukkha is also there. So these are the three types of dukkham that we have in Vedanta. Now dukkhanam kshatihi, if all these types of dukkhas are gone, all this suffering, removal of these three types of suffering is moksha. That is one people say. Another set of people are saying, no, 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 just the removal of suffering is not enough. Abodha hatihi. There is something called ajnana beyond this. You know, when you are sleeping, you don't have any suffering. You wake up, you say, sukamaham asvapsam nakinchit avedisham. I slept very well. I don't remember anything. Does that mean that every time you go into deep sleep, are you in moksha state? No. There is something called ajnana. You come back to say that I slept, that I factor should go. It's only when that I factor goes, that is called abodha hatihi. Abodha is ajnana. It is the destruction of that last film or that maya that's there. You know, that it's like a curtain. You just have to remove that curtain. That is moksha. Now, that also is not enough. If you just remove the ajnana, ananda vispurtihi iti, you know, that anandam that comes after the removal of the ajnana, that ananda vispurtihi or the swayam prakasha swarupam, that is called moksha. Iti antarvani vikalpa jala jatilat mokshadapi jayasi Yam Amaravati. Now, how is this greater than such a complicated concept of moksha? Ya Yesha Avipratipanna Saukhya Lahari Sampata Sambhavi. You cannot have any such doubts when you are trying to attain Swarga. That is where our Purva Mimamsa comes into play. You cannot. You have to believe in the words of Shruti. If it says Swarga Kamo Yajeta, you perform a yaga and you will get Swarga. That's all there is to it. There is no doubt, no confusion, no form of, you know, how will you get it? What will happen to this? Yes, there is. In the sense, you perform this yagam. They say very simply, you perform a yaga. That yagam takes a form of something called apurvam, which is you can't see now. And at some point when it has to realize, that apurvam will come into force and you will get swarga. That's it. It's so easy. So avipratipanna, pratipatti is knowledge. Vipratipatti is confusing knowledge. All this sort of wrong knowledge. Mithya jnana. Avipratipanna is amithya jnanena utpanna. Satya jnanena utpanna, which is shruti. Shruti vakyena utpanna. So it is saukhyam. There is no vikalpa there. No problem. And it is not jatila. It is lahari. It's like a flow of thought. See, Shraddha is such a beautiful thing that the moment you have Shraddha on something, you will be, so many other thoughts will come, but still you will be in that flow of thought, in that flow of Shraddha. That is what Shruti Vakyam says. If Shruti Vakyam, if you believe completely in the Veda Vakya, avipratipanna, saukhya, that happiness of believing, that swarga saukhyam can be attained. If you believe in that, that is that thought, that saukhyam is like a lahari flow. And from that flow, sampata, sampata is sampata sambhadini, that is the lahari sampata is called the flow that falls in your mind. It seems very synonymous, so take it as the flow of river. It's like that. So sampadini, from that flow of thought, you get this Amaravati. Sampadini, ya, that Amaravati which is got from this flow of thought, which is not, which does not have any false knowledge. Tat saundarya vivechane, tasyaha amaravatyaha saundarya vivechane, to analyze the beauty of that, krimatam kavayatam maunam kshamam. People are very, you know, many poets have tried to describe the moksha, but when they come to describe Amaravati, they are very shy about describing it because they don't know. So they keep quiet. Maunam kshamam, maunam eva arham tesha. In the sense, many people have not seen it fit to describe Amaravati because there is no other point, there is no point in discussing about it. Moksha, there are so many different thoughts about it. There are so many dilemma about how the moksha swarupa is. Amaravati, there is just one belief. That's all. So why should we discuss about it? Krimatam, why he says they have, they are very shy. It's not that they feel ashamed about it. They are very shy in describing all these things. They don't want to take courage and describe about Amaravati. And that's why, so in effect, what the Kavi is trying to say is the dhvani here is, he says, I have taken a very bold step in trying to describe how Amaravati could be. It is my imagination. Even if it is an imagination, I have taken quite a bold step in doing this. Right? We have to applaud him for that. So, dukkhanam kshatiriti, abodha hatiriti, ananda vispurthiriti, antarvani vikalpa jala jatilapa, mokshadapi jayasi, ya esha avipratipanna saukhya lahari sampata sambhadini, tat saundarya vivechane kavayata maunam kshamam hrimata. Okay, I have time for one more. Next one.
ಆನೀತಾ ವಸುಧಾಮಲಾ சுகிருதினஸ்தஸ்யாம் ஹரேஷ் சாசனாத் உம்மீலன் மணி கிங்கணி கிங்கிணி கலகலஸ்வானே விமானே ஸ்திதாக திருஷ்ட்வா வியோம நிராஸ்பதம் ச சகித வியாபூர்ணமானேக்ஷணா ந ஸ்தாதும் ந ச வா ததோ அவதரிதும் ராகல்பயம் ஆபிப்ரதே
பிராகல்பியம் ஆபிப்ரதே
பிராகல்பியம்
பிராகல்பியம் இஸ் திருஷ்டதா தைரியம் சோ ஹரேஹே சாசனாத் வசுதாதலாத் சுகிருதினா ஆனீதாஹ நவ் இன் திஸ் அமராவதி நவ் வி நோ தட் திஸ் அமராவதி மெனி பீப்புள் டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு டிஸ்கிரைப் இட் நவ் தி வை பிகாஸ் த லாட் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் ஹூ கம் ஹியர் ஆல்சோ லுக் எட் அமராவதி அண்ட் தே ஆர் totally surprised and they don't know what to do. They don't know whether to stand there or to get down or to go back or what. So vasudha anitaha vasudhatalat sukritinaha tasyam tasyam amaravatyam harehe shasanat hari is indra here yeah actually yama anila indra chandra vishnu simha you have bheka many things are hari contextually here we fix it based on the context saying hare he shasanat sukritinah amaravatyam anitaha when you say amaravati the word amaravati itself confines the meaning of hari as indra so indrasya shasanat because of the orders of indra sukritinah those who have performed karma in the bhuloka they are sukriti sukritinaha vasudatalat anitaha those good people who have been brought from the vasudha bhumi anitaha what do they do unmilat mani kinkini kalakala swane vimane sthitaha unmilat samudbhavat mani kinkini kalakala swane vimane now how have they been brought from bhumi in a vimana in a vehicle so indra sends one vehicle and says all of you can come so vimane sthitaha now they are standing there and looking at the moment before you land on an aeroplane if you are standing there you look down on the city right you see the city line that's how they are all standing you have to imagine them standing in a vehicle like this it's an open air open thingy which so they can see that so vimane sthitaha they are in one vehicle and how is that vimana unmilat unmilathu the sound is coming what sound mani kinkini kalakala swane the vimana has a lot of mani in it jewels or you know the small tiny bells that are hanging in your anklet it's like that makes a sound that is called kinkini those hanging little bells are called kinkini mani kinkini kalakala swana they make a noise called kalakala kalakala that is a it is an onomatopoeic word so kalakala iti swanam kurvan swana is dhvani yeah that's what I was looking for swana is the noise that comes out from the small bells that are hanging in that vimana so tadrisha vimane sthitaha sukritinah what do they do niraspadam vyomam drushtva they look at this vyoma akasha and niraspadam akasham drishtva in here you should say that the akasha the ashraya in which the amaravati stands that has no support so it is they are not surprised by seeing the akasham to be without support they look at amaravatyaha aspadam niraspadam vyoma iti drishtva that you anvay make an anvaya like that not just by looking at the supportless akasha that's not what they can't be surprised by that because even from bhumi they can see the akasham and they can see that it is just like that right there is no support there that is fine here how do you have to take it as amaravatyaha aspadam niraspadam vyoma iti drishtva they find that there is no moola shila anapekshita moola shila yeah we saw that in that first paragraph so there is no expectancy there is no necessity for any foundation so niraspadam vyoma drishtva they saw that amaravati was standing in a supportless akasham after seeing that what happens sachakita they're first afraid. If you see something surprising, the first thing you feel is frightening. Then you analyze whether it is a good surprise or a bad surprise. The first thing is you're afraid. So such akita, that is the first reaction from them. So such akita, then vyagurnamana ikshana. They keep on looking everywhere, so their eyes are roaming around. Vyagurnamana. So they keep roaming, their eyes keep roaming around. And then what happens? Na sthatum tataha avataritum va pragalbhyam na abhidrate. They don't have the courage to either stand there in that vimana or to get down from there and enjoy everything. First, they are so surprised. They are afraid of it. And then they don't know what to look at. Now, next, sthatum na abhidrate. Pragalbhyam na abhidrate. Pragalbhyam is dhairyam. Statum dairyam navahanti tataha vimanataha vimanat avataritum api na prabhavanti. They don't have the courage to even get down or stand there. So they're just they're standing there like a stambha. They don't know what to do. So anita vasudatalat sukritinaha tasyam haresh shasanat Unmilat mani kinkini kalakala swane vimane sthitaha. Drishtva vyoma niraspadam sachakita vyaghurnamane kshana nastatum najava tato avataritum pragalbhyam abhibhrate. We'll stop with this. Okay, there is a nice comparison that Kamakshi has brought out. Na yayo natastho in Kumara Sambhava, Shailadhiraja tanaya na yayo natastho. When she's doing tapas, Shiva comes and he catches hold of her hand. He continuously keeps on arguing and saying, you know, why do you have to look at Shiva? He is not worth it. He is on an ox. He wears a gaja charma. He comes up with all sorts of different explanations as to why Parvati should not marry Shiva. Shiva himself comes there in the disguise of a brahmachari. And at that point of time, she says, I don't want to talk to him. Ask him to get out. She tells her Sakhi. At that point of time when she says, get out, I don't want to talk to you, Shiva catches hold of her hand and he says, even before he says anything, she says, the Kalidasa says there, na yayo natastho, Shailadhiraja tanaya. So she is the daughter of Himaman in this Janma, but she is Bhavapurva Patni. She was the wife, his wife. So when Shiva comes and holds her hand, it is her duty to stand there. And she also wants to stand there because she is Bhavapurva Patni. Because of that, na yayo. At the same time, she could not stand there because she is Shailadhiraja Tanaya. He uses that particular adjective in that shloka for that. She is still not married because she is Himavan's daughter in this. So na yayo, na tasthau, nor could she go, nor could she stand. It's the dilemma that she faced at that point of time. A nice comparison. Nastatum, nachava, tataha, avataritum, pragalbhyam, abhibhrate.